In Module 4, I'll guide you through Operations Manager integration, which we also call Advisor as an attached service. Going back to our high-level architecture diagram, this is where we'll discuss how to use Advisor in an Operations Manager environment without the need to install separate Advisor software. Some notes before we kick off the demo. Availability for this is out of the box in System Center 2012 R2, Operations Manager. A download is also available for System Center 2012 SP1, Operations Manager, and we recommend also installing the latest update rollup for SP1. What this will bring you is you can view advisor alerts, not just in the advisor portal, but also in Operations Manager. Since you don't need to install a separate advisor gateway or a separate advisor agent, this will simplify deployment greatly. And finally, you will be able to use all the available Operations Manager alert functionality like ticketing and reporting on the advisor alerts. So now I'm going to move to my Operations Manager integration demo, and I already have an environment where I've installed Operations Manager with two management servers and several agents, and I will show you how to enable Advisor as an attached service. We are now in the Operations Manager console, which is where you can view Operations Manager alerts, author management packs, and also change settings for Operations Manager. As of Operations Manager 2012 R2, we now have a System Center Advisor section under administration that ships right out of the box. I've already configured this environment, but just to show you how simple it is, I'll go into Advisor Connection, and under Actions, you will see Reconfigure Advisor if you've already configured it, but if it's your first time, you'll see Configure Advisor. And all I needed to do was click this link, and I will receive the same wizard that I received the first time I onboarded to Advisor. All I need to do here is provide the same Microsoft account I am using for Advisor and log in, which will perform the action of getting that registration certificate that we did in Module 3. And at this point, I can either create a new Advisor account or I can select an existing account. And you can see that already Operations Manager has grabbed the Contoso account I used in Module 2 and the Advisor MVA account that I created in Module 3. So I'm going to use Contoso for the purposes of this demo, and I'm just going to click Next. And at this point, all I would need to do is confirm my settings that this is the right Microsoft account and this is the right Advisor account. I won't update these settings since I don't want to change the demo in any way. And I'll go back to administration. And from here, you can also start adding computers or computer groups to be monitored by Advisor. By default, we will not add anything, and you will have the ability to opt in a group or individual computers. What I've already done is I've already opted in three objects. And this is the regular computer search screen for Operations Manager, where I can select Windows Server or instance groups. And when I search, I will see all the computers that Operations Manager is currently monitoring. And I can add or remove objects from this list into my Advisor managed list. And that is all you need to do to set up Advisor in Operations Manager. If you'd also like, you can configure proxy server from here, and you can start managing alert rules if you already know there's some rules that you'd like to ignore. Now, after you've added computer groups or computers, you can go back and see them in administration under Advisor Managed. And here we'll see the three items that I had already opted into Advisor. And if I want to add more items, I can still go to the Add Computer Group screen from here. Now, this is all ready for Advisor monitoring. And all I need to do is wait some time until Advisor analyzes the data from these agents, and I can go into the monitoring pane to begin seeing alerts. And now what we will see is the System Center Advisor folder that contains the exact same Advisor alerts that I saw in the Advisor portal, now in the Operations Manager console. And if you notice carefully, these are the same alerts we discussed in an earlier module. The server that's having a security configuration problem that will not allow Advisor to function. We have databases present without backups and problems with clean consistency check. I can select any of these alerts, and get the alert detail to explain to me what the issue is about. And from here, I can always go to the KB article that will give me the solution for this particular issue. Just like you can with other Operation Manager alerts, you can ignore close alerts, and you can also manage the same advisor alert rules that you have on the portal. One of the most valuable features from the advisor as an attached service is that you can also monitor the advisor health state to know exactly how your agents and your management servers are. And you can see here that all three of my agents are healthy and my management servers as well. If I needed to know more about what is the health of these agents, I can select an agent or a management server and go into Health Explorer, which is one of the key features of Operations Manager. And within here, I can see what is the definition of health for an advisor agent or for the management servers. And you can look through this and understand what are the different tasks that make up a healthy advisor agent and detect any problems and find their solution if you need to. And that is it. That is all. So it's very straightforward to onboard to advisor from Operations Manager. All you need is your Microsoft account and either an existing or a new account to make with advisor. And you can begin adding computers and computer groups to Operations Manager and start receiving configuration assessment for advisor in Operations Manager. And that's all for the Operations Manager integration demo and this course. I hope this has piqued your interest in Advisor and that you found it very useful. Thank you for trying this out, and I hope you enjoy Advisor.